Declaring a class as abstract means that a class can contain incomplete methods that must be implemented in deriving classes. The abstract class can therefore, in addition to normal class members, also contain abstract methods. These methods are left unimplemented and only specify their signatures, while their bodies are replaced by semicolons. If we create a class called Rectangle that inherits from the abstract class called Shape, Rectangle is then forced to override the abstract method, unless Rectangle is declared abstract as well, in which case it does not have to implement any abstract methods. An abstract class cannot be instantiated, but we can use it to encapsulate any of its subclasses. Even though it cannot be instantiated, an abstract class can still have constructors, which can be called from the subclass's constructors using the super keyword. If we compare abstract classes to interfaces, we find that they are similar in many ways. They can both define method signatures that subclasses must implement, and neither one of them can be instantiated. The key differences are first that the abstract class can contain any non-abstract members, while the interface cannot, and second, that a class can implement any number of interfaces, but only inherit from one class, abstract or not. We generally use an interface either to specify a specific functionality that a class can have, or to provide an interface to other programmers using our classes. And we use an abstract class when we want to provide a partial implementation, leaving it up to the subclasses to complete it. This is useful when the subclasses have a lot of functionality in common, but also have some functionality that must be implemented differently for each subclass. Note that an abstract class can, just as a non-abstract class, extend one superclass and implement any number of interfaces. An interface, however, cannot inherit from a class, but it can extend another interface, which effectively combines the two interfaces into one.